So today, I'm reacting to the trailer that everyone has been waiting for, and I'm so excited to review this trailer. Don't Look Up. I don't think that's right. Wasn't the No Way Home trailer supposed to drop today? I don't even know anymore. No, there is a new trailer for a new Netflix movie called Don't Look Up. It stars a whole bunch of people, surprisingly. You got Leonardo DiCaprio, Jennifer Lawrence, Meryl Streep, Jonah Hill, Cate Blanchett, Tyler Perry, Timothy Chalamet, Mark Rylance. Kid Cudi's in this movie for some reason. There's a whole bunch of people in this movie for some reason, and I don't know why. I don't know. And also, what's really interesting is that Adam McKay is directing this. If you don't know who he is, he did movies like The Big Short and Vice. And he's had a very interesting career. He started off, you know, with Funny or Die and all that, and then he kind of moved on to, like, directing all these comedies starring Will Ferrell, like Talladega Nights, Anchorman 1 and 2, Step Brothers. And so he's gone from that to being an Oscar-caliber director? That's interesting. And it seems to be working. People really... Well, not really. I think Vice was pretty divisive. I thought it was fine. But I don't know about this. I really don't know. This is not based on anything. This is an original story. And I guess, like, based on the poster, it says based on a possible true story. So is this going to be, like, a warning? Like, a movie that's basically a warning? I don't know. It sounds pretty interesting. It's about, you know, two scientists played by DiCaprio and Lawrence. They basically go on this tour to basically warn everyone, hey, the world's going to end, and it's going to be caused by an asteroid. And I guess, like, I remember the first teaser didn't show too much. It was just that little clip where it's the two of them plus Streep as the president and Jonah Hill as, I guess, her chief of staff. I don't know. And, like, he's kind of freaking out, but not really, and she doesn't really care. And like, okay, that's going to be the vibe of this movie, I guess. So we'll wait and see. And also, this movie comes out in about a month on Netflix. I believe it comes out on Christmas Eve on Netflix. So, yay, perfect Christmas movie. Here's a movie about the end of the world. And also, last thing before I watch the trailer. I haven't seen anything about this beforehand. So I think it's like one of the last award season movies to release anything. And there's like been no screenings or anything. So that's interesting. I don't know what the deal is quite yet, but I don't know. It's like that, and like the new West Side Story hasn't really released anything other than trailers, so let's just watch this thing finally. Let's just take a look. Turn the volume up.
This is not real.
Based on real events.
This is not real. This isn't happening.
That haven't happened.
Tell me this isn't really happening.
I hear there's something you don't like the looks of.
We discovered a very large comet.
Oh, good for you.
It's headed directly towards Earth.
This comet is what we call a planet killer.
At this exact moment, I say we sit tight and assess.
Sit tight and assess?
Sit tight.
And then assess. The sit tight part comes first, and you gotta digest it. That's the assessment period.
This is the worst news in the history of humanity. He just blew us off.
What are we gonna do? We have to release the information.
So we just leak it.
Our guests today have made a pretty big discovery in space.
How big is this thing going? I can't destroy my ex-wife's house. Is that possible?
There's a 100% chance that we're all going to die.
Hey.
Well, the handsome astronomer can go back anytime, but the yelling lady, not so much.
Oh, my God.
We're going to get the news out there one way or another.
It's real and it's coming.
FBI!
Jesus Christ, you could have just called me.
This comet contains $30 trillion worth of material.
What if trillions of dollars matter if we're all going to die?
Oh, no, we're rich. That would be terrible.
My God.
Discovered a comet. I have a tattoo of a shooting star on my back.
Oh, that's terrific.
Is that Ariana Grande?
This could be a complete disaster.
This is already a disaster.
You're on Sesame Street, of all things.
You hear that girl from YFTV said we're all gonna die?
No.
Oh my God, why?
You'll never take me alive!
The FBI
put that bag over your head. They don't do that. The CIA does, but I made them do it.
You know, I had a feeling.
It's a good feeling, because that is what I did, and it was very funny and cool.
Looks like it could be interesting. I feel like a lot of the comedy, at least, it just feels like they're just literally saying the same joke over and over again. Just mainly from Jonah Hill, where he's like, they say the joke, and then he tries to explain it, and it just doesn't work. Kind of what I just did, actually. And I guess that it's not that funny. It's like, I guess that's going to be the humor. And I guess a lot of the humor is going to come from, you know, these people who just don't believe him, like Meryl Streep's the president, she doesn't believe them. You got Cate Blanchett and Tyler Perry as news anchors, they don't believe them. Ariana Grande is maybe appearing in the movie as herself, I don't know. Like, she doesn't believe them. So this movie was, like, in development way before COVID. And, yeah, it kind of makes sense where it's like, oh, this is a movie about how there's this really big thing that's happening and people are not prepared. And, you know, these experts are trying to tell everyone, trying to warn everyone, take this thing seriously. This is happening. And no one's taking it seriously. They're all kind of like being like, hey, we'll make money off it. Or we'll be really rich and really famous. And like, yeah, that's kind of what this last year was like. And I guess, it looks all right. I don't know how far it'll go at the Oscars. I feel, first off, there's usually just a lot of contenders every year, so it's just like, will this movie actually get noticed or anything? And I don't know, maybe the subject matter just won't really, I don't know. I don't know just quite yet. I'm not saying you shouldn't make a comedy about this. I don't have any problems with that. I guess more, I just wish the trailer was funnier. As far as the performances go, you kind of got a sense of, like, almost everyone. I kind of got a little bit more of Meryl Streep from the teaser than I did from this. Leonardo DiCaprio, he looks like he's given a very different performance as this panicky type of scientist. I thought he seems like he's having a good time. Well, not really a good time. It's actually an interesting performance for him. I don't think I've ever really seen him do that. Cate Blanchett, I kind of liked her as this, like this news anchor who looked like he's like always trying to smile and like always like kind of like upset. It's like, oh, this news, I don't like this news, so I don't want to talk about it or something like that. So I kind of liked that. Jonah Hill, I didn't really care for. Most of the performances were like too small to notice. Like, you know, Ron Perlman, I saw him. He looks like he's having a blast. He's just shooting his gun. Timothée Chalamet, Ariana Grande, I heard Chris Evans was supposed to be in this movie. Where was he? He's not on the poster. He's not in this trailer. Is it like that Matt Damon and Interstellar thing? We knew Matt Damon was going to be in Interstellar. And yet, it was already ruined. So is it like a big surprise? I don't know. But overall, I don't know how this will do in awards season. I don't. I want it to succeed, but maybe it will. Maybe it just won't get any awards. Hopefully people will enjoy it, and maybe hopefully people will rethink their lives. So there's that. So did you watch the trailer for Don't Look Up? Are you excited for this movie? What's your favorite ensemble movie? Because this is a pretty big ensemble cast. Again, you got all these people involved. So comment down below, subscribe to the channel. This is Pat, and stay safe.